Yay, we haven't done this in a while, I suppose. Alright, so how's it going, everybody? My name is Zero Matter.
I'm Generations.
And this particular video is going to be not streamed, but recorded and placed across three different platforms. Channels, rather.
Yes, correct.
So this will probably be our first video here on... Which channel are we on?
Right now, we're going to be going through three channels. So you're going to be seeing this video on my channel, Generations, his channel, Zero Matter 128, and then our third channel that we haven't really mentioned in a while, and that's our collab channel, Zero Genetics.
Yep, we're going to definitely try and just pump out as much content as we can on that one, so not everything's left in the dark. I feel like this one is just going to be all over the place. It's going to have a mixture of a combination of a lot of things.
Right, so today's video, so in the beginning of the month was his birthday.
Hey.
So his best friends decided to get him a very big present.
Which I'm very angry about.
So it is it's going to be pictured somewhere around here. A Deadmau5 gaming chair. It's gonna be pictured somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere.
Don't know where. Yes. So we're gonna be building that today. It's gonna be fun.
And hopefully it's not gonna be too time consuming.
Right.
We'll see how it goes.
It came in a giant box. You'll see that in just a moment. But I hope you guys enjoy this video. Be sure to give us a like if you want more videos on all three channels, since you'll be watching them on. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the video.
If not, then at least give a like for the puppers.
Yeah. See you in a little bit.
Hi, puppy. Okay, so this is the gigantic box that we probably should have just put a picture of over here. I'm sure we'll take better pictures of it somewhere. Yeah, this thing is huge and it weighs a lot. A real lot. So from what I'm reading the instructions here, if you want to get a shot of this, Jen. I guess this goes for anyone and everyone that's gonna get a secret lab chair. There's gonna be a caution warning, and it clearly says, do not touch backrest recliner lever while removing from box and until backrest is securely installed. I don't exactly know how that is gonna affect our building skills, but we'll see how it goes. All right, here we go. We're opening this bad boy up for the very first time. Never done. This is only going to be, at least on my channel, this is going to be the second time where I've done like a do-it-yourself sort of thing intro.
Yeah, because you built your computer on your channel.
My PC that's sitting right there. You can check that out on my channel if you're watching this on a different channel.
Yep.
Okay, so.
Look at this thing, guys.
Already, this thing is.
It's got, of course you open up and you see the Deadmau5.
Yup. This thing is huge.
It smells like leather, just
yeah,
so you guys
it
know.
It does. This thing is gigantic and heavy.
Oh.
I'm gonna try and lay out these parts as best as I can.
Oh my god!
Here. This thing's gonna slip too, so.
Ooh!
That's cool.
That's actually the back.
Yep.
Okay, yeah, put it on the couch, I guess.
Yeah, I'll put that there.
Wow. Ooh.
These things are ginormous.
Hi, puppy.
Yeah, this isn't your average office chair. For those, if there are parents watching this, this isn't your average office chair.
No, it's not.
This is, I'm assuming, what your kid would be dreaming of when they want a game and just have a very nice setup. I don't even know, like this thing here. You think this is the headrest?
I think it's a headrest or...
It's pretty comfortable, actually, not gonna lie.
I'm not so sure about it, but it looks really cool.
What is this?
I think it maybe goes for your back.
Oh,
I think it's the cushion for your back. I could be wrong though.
See that Omega?
Yes, Omega Secret Lab is the company that Deadmau5 chose to go with to make his special chair.
I'm trying to be somewhat delicate here. Oh, look at this. I didn't even know this was gonna be a part of it.
What is it?
It's an accessory box.
Ooh.
I don't know what this is, but I'm assuming it's gotta be like, I don't know, the aesthetics, whatever. Let's open it up.
Hi, Jack.
Contents. Oh, okay.
So that's this is the tools.
This is the tools that come with. So you got an Allen key, M8 screws and washers. You got four of them. Reversible Phillips and a hex screw bit. One magnetic screwdriver handle. Also one. Extra large. What is this? Oh, casters. Five. You got side covers, two, and lever handles for multi-tilt only, times two. And hydraulic piston and hydraulic sleeve, one. Interesting. Oh, I see already. So check this out.
Oh, those must be the wheels.
Yeah. I hope, let's see. Hope I can take it out one by one. Okay, cool. I can showcase them like that. No, Jack. Can't build. My dog wishes he could build it.
He gets pets though.
He does get pets.
He has to be leaning against something. He has to be.
It's an interesting box. I might even keep it. Here we go. So here's the toolkit that they give you.
Cool.
Nice. Right, I want to see if I can take out everything else before I get way out of myself. This is, oh wow, I see it's exciting.
That's the base. I think, or for the wheels.
For the wheels.
Yeah, so I think we have to assemble that first, if anything.
Oh yeah.
That's gonna be the first thing. I think that's what the directions actually say.
This is, yeah.
Ooh, that looks like the butt.
Yeah, hold on.
That's for the butt.
Do not touch. Even though I just touched it, but all right, so I guess we'll leave this for last because this is clearly, you can see here, the third.
We can't touch the handle, but we can touch the seat itself.
Clearly, this is the third time that they're telling us to not touch that. I guess it's
some sort of safety issue.
Probably. Oh my God.
Wow.
This is what was heavy. I was
really?
Like, it didn't feel that heavy with everything else. This is definitely the one that's
heavy. It's gotta be like a hydraulic system.
Oh my God.
Wow.
Definitely a lot heavier than what I was expecting.
Yeah, Jack, you don't like that.
Big box.
I don't like it either.
What the heck is it? Hold on, there's still another part in here, actually. Oh, hey, that's greased up.
Oh, that looks like it's for the part above the chair.
Yeah.
That's the so you can lift it up and down, I guess.
Get a close up of this.
Cool. That's the hydraulic system, I guess.
All right, so we're gonna leave that there. Okay.
So these are pretty much all the parts laid out.
This is gonna be nuts. This is gonna be an intense build already.
Yes.
Can we close this up? Unless, Jack, you want a new home? I can't believe that. Okay. So, congratulations. You are now the owner of a brand new Secret Lab chair. You're just steps away from your ultimate seating experience. Flip this sheet over and you'll find a quick start guide to assembling your Secret Lab chair. We highly recommend checking out our assembly video as well for even more detailed and visual instructions. Before you get started, a few pointers. Have a friend to help make, having a friend makes assembly extra easy. Mind the important safety information and contact us if you need any issues. And this is a manual to build this chair.
Yay.
This is gonna be fun.
Yep. Step one, get the base. And get the wheels.
Yeah.
We are assembling the wheels first.
Wheels. Careful. This is heavy than I thought. That fresh new smell.
Yay. Jack came to sit with me again.
All right. Just gonna go here. casters. The five casters. This would be the wheels here. So that's obviously different to you. Alright, so step number two, it says turn the wheelbase the right side up and insert the hydraulic piston. Slide the hydraulic sleeve over the piston. So it's gonna be like this. Already looks nice just like that.
It does.
And then this part will be found where you found the toolkits. Take this off. This end here, this piston, is gonna go this way. So the longer or the thinner side is gonna go just like so. Then this is the sleeve that comes with it. Kind of fun. This goes over it. There we go.
Now we're gonna move on to step number three. We're gonna fit this away.
Alright, so step number three involves this being pushed to the side at least, or I mean, it's going to be self-explanatory at that point, because then it's telling us to go to the actual backrest itself. Always practice safety when using a knife.
Yes, correct.
Okay, so now, since all four of the screws, as you can see here, are still together, we now go to step four, which actually involves that thing.
Yay.
Right there. So this is actually going to go to the side over here. Here we go. Unravel all this garbage. Okay, so if you bring it over here, it clearly says here, do not remove this strap until the backrest has been securely installed. So we're not gonna be badasses here and, you know, try and take the shortcut route. I'm sure Secret Lab would wanna see this thing done the right way. So we're just gonna leave it here and just follow the instructions because we're good people.
Oh, yes, it's there.
Oh, I see why they... Okay, that's why. Yeah, this part is very important.
It's all coming together.
And let's make sure, actually, if you can get over here, you're going to see why this part is super important. Get a shot of this in there. You're going to see that it's probably not going to line up correctly, but the directions do tell you that make sure when you're going to... We're about to put in two of those in there. They only tell you to do it halfway. This is going to be like the main placeholder. Small cameo on the chair, but you won't be on the chair itself. All right, so to explain step four, it's like this. On this side, you want to make sure you go about halfway on each one. And when they say make sure that you keep pushing this thing into this on this rod until it stops, they're not kidding. They're not lying. Actually, you had to really go in there and make sure that it's fully in so that way these guys can sit there comfortably. Because step five is going to be the opposite side with the other two that we took out before, only this time that other side is a little more free. Because I know you won't be able to see much of it, so this will be a better way to display it. This thing here moves freely than the other one, so that's why the other one was held in place. This one you're really gonna have to kind of work for a little bit, just not too much, but this one should be a little easier to install. You definitely want to make sure that the alignment over here kind of does matter, because my suggestion to you is you start with the top piece first, just so it kind of already holds it together right here. Then this part just kind of slides in on its own. You really just got to focus on the parts here and here and where to push, and then eventually this bad boy lines up pretty perfectly on its own. Again, I think now we're just going to go about tightening the bolts, and then eventually we can finally release this thing, this caution, because everything will finally be together. Step six, from what we're at right now, I believe, after tightening all the nuts and bolts that are on the sides over here, as we demonstrated before, we have to put on these bad boys right here.
Look like they're covered to those nuts and bolts.
Yep. And it looks like, let me see, how are they supposed to go? Oh, that's kind of cool. Are they the same way, or is it just...
Maybe they just look like that, or they slide on.
That's true.
Maybe they just slide on.
No, they definitely just clip on like that.
That's amazing.
That's
convenient.
Nice.
That's convenient. Wow.
Oh, okay, I got it. So the other side, do you want to try on the other side?
No, but I'll try.
This is Jen's first attempt at building something.
I did it.
Nice. They're magnetic. That's what it says. They're really just meant to just go right on top of it. Going into step number seven, remove the recline strap. Then using the Phillips screwdriver, I'm assuming it's gonna be underneath when I do that. So we're gonna remove this. We can finally do that. The train wheels are off. There we go.
Yay.
All right, and if whoever decides to show this to Omega/Yucatlab, we follow the instructions all the way through. We ain't just cut this just because. So yeah. All right.
Into our pile of garbage.
So, do you want to just pass me that? The camera. Sure, right here. Ah. That's Jen.
Hi.
All right, so right here, that's gonna say, you know, caution, roughly. Right there. And actually, yeah, here we go. Inside the little bugger, that guy's gonna have to come out. It's a red screw they were talking about. Yes. That was hiding underneath the covering. And I'm gonna see if I can try and do it this way, actually. With my handy dandy tool over here. This is magnetic too, by the way. I thought this was pretty cool. See? All right, let's do this. There's the red screw they were talking about. Neato, yeah. Keep this over here, and here you go. And it's already making me on edge just kind of thinking about it, but step eight actually requires us to kind of tilt said bad boy over. And as you can see before, it was kind of tilting backwards, and now it's a little more straight. What? Oh man, all this together. Let's see how it comes to fruition. Because step eight requires this to go underneath over here. Ooh, this is gonna be difficult. This part is gonna attach like so, not like this. The metal bar here, come closer if you will, assistant, is gonna be placed like so. It's gonna go like that. And the four screws, you're probably wondering where the heck they are. Well, that's where these guys come in handy. Everything, they gave you everything. It's not like you're gonna need anything new. The four screws that are gonna be attaching this to that are right here, that was located with the Allen key. We go to step 10, right here, this thing. Thing looks like a gun, pew pew. It says line up the grooves inside the lever handles with the notches and insert until it clicks into place. So like so. There we go. Yep, that works. And where's the other one? The other one's over here. Somewhat moment of truth here is we're gonna take for the final semi-final step, the final step is actually sitting in it. We're gonna take this and attach it onto this bad boy, and hopefully everything comes.
Well, technically you have to attach that to that.
Gotta do it carefully. Whew. Okay, let's see if this works.
tacos. That's it?
And let's see if it comes together. Now I gotta be extra delicate with it, as it says.
Oh, it stands.
And there we have it. We have our chair. Yay, that's it, I think.
Not yet.
Not yet.
Let's at least clean this area up, and then we'll show the aftershoots.
Sure. To go ahead and sit in the chair. What's not added, but I'm sure I will add later, is the headrest and the backrest. Yeah, I'm assuming that's what it's for. Okay, so here we go. Hopefully it doesn't break on me. Yep, this is exactly what I was expecting it to be. Oh my god, I like the slowness of it here. Like, oh my god, I actually my feet up over here. Short people problems. This is pretty good. I've never sat in a chair like this before. I've always sat in computer chairs or, you know, whatever the standard household desk chair is. I always thought those are pretty cool, but this beats any chair I'm sure I've ever sat in. As far as a desktop chair goes or a gaming chair goes, the ultimate experience, yeah, totally worth it. Let's see, so the mechanisms here. There's a lever that we use over here. This kind of raises and lowers the seat. So we know that works. There's two buttons here. These tilt outward or inward. I'm just gonna keep them straight, I think, right? Right here. There's levers on the side right here, if you can see that. These make the thing go up and down, the handles. And they stay securely in place. It's very, very good. And there's other buttons. There's three buttons on the handles here. These make them slide left and right. In. Like a DJ turntable thing, sort of does. Quality, definitely top notch. 10 out of 10 Secret Labs and Mr. Mouse / Dead Mouse. Good. I'm not complaining about this chair. This chair is comfortable. I was reading some other things here. This chair is comfortable, okay? It is every amount of comfortable that you would expect it to be, and it's very smooth even after the final finish, after you built the whole thing. Very, very good, and it's very, and I like the feeling of this, and honestly, it's just, I have to get used to that obviously, but this is nice. This is very, very good. Totally worth it. And now here's some very, very lousy shots of us doing whatever, and before we get into that, Generations is going to take a seat.
Okay, so now it's my turn. I've never sat in a chair like this either. Even when I went to like PAX East or Comic-Con or NYC, I've never sat in any of these kind of chairs. I'm excited. I've seen a bunch of YouTubers and streamers with these kind of chairs, and I've always wanted one. So I will get mine someday. Just not right now, but I am going to get it.
Oh wait, not before
maybe,
before you.
Maybe not this specific one, but maybe a different color.
Before you sit down, why don't you give us the back of that shirt?
Back of the shirt? Oh yeah, this is one of my my new Dead Mouse merch that I just bought like a couple weeks ago, and it finally came in the mail. I love it. It's probably one of my favorite shirts. It's got my two favorite colors on it, purple and yellow. So I'm now gonna sit in it. Comfortable chair I've ever sat. Oh my god, my feet don't touch the ground. even if it's the lowest, it's my feet don't touch the ground. So how do I put it down? Wait, like this? Is this this too low, actually. This is perfect right here. Right here. Wow, this is the most comfortable chair I've ever
seen. Take one good spin. Oh, there's a handle right there.
Where? Here?
Yep, right there.
Oh god. I can probably sleep with this chair. I'm gonna spin.